Donald Trump did his first interview with his VP, Mike Pence, and it was a disaster.
A lot of the conservatives are very happy.
Very happy.
Was that part of the
It was part of unity. I'm an outsider. I'm a person that used to be establishment when I'd give them hundreds of thousands of dollars. But when I decided to run, I became very anti-establishment because I understand the system better than anybody else. He's very establishment in many ways, and that's not a bad thing. But I will...
John McCain.
Do you think he went too far?
You could say yes. That's okay. You could say yes. I mean, you know, it's fine. Hey, look, I like John McCain. But we have to take care of our vets.
No, but I want to know if Mr. Pence would go in and
that's
say
why
to you,
that many people
what,
are upset.
What did you say?
He speaks from his heart. And
I speak from my heart and my brain, just so we understand. Many people speak for them.
Right.
This is maybe more important.
This good man, I believe, will be a great president of the United States.
I love what he just said. And we're going to declare war. It is war. When the World Trade Center comes tumbling down with thousands of people being killed, people are still, I have friends that are still
suffering. Well, we did go to war, if you remember. We went to Iraq.
Yeah, you went to Iraq, but that was handled so badly. And that was a war. By the way, that was a war that we shouldn't have done because Iraq did not knock down.
Your running mate
Iraq did not
voted for
down.
It.
I don't care.
What do you mean you don't care that he voted?
It's a long time ago. And he voted that way, and they were also misled. A lot of information was given to people, but I was against the war in Iraq from the beginning.
Yeah, but you used that vote that of Hillary's, that was the same as Governor Pence,
many people
as the example of her bad judgment.
Many people have, and frankly, I'm one of the few that was right on Iraq.
Yeah, but what about he did?
He's entitled to make a mistake every once in a while.
But she's not. Okay, come on.
But she's not.
She's not.
No, she's not.
Got it.
That was precious. Trump forgot how logic worked. War in Iraq, terrible idea. Hillary Clinton voted for her. Bad, terrible, bad for the country, bad. Well, your running mate also voted for it. Not only voted for it, was one of the most vocal advocates for it. Repeated all the now debunked talking points that were just dead wrong. Was a cheerleader for the Iraq War. I don't care. He was a long time ago. He's entitled to make a mistake every once in a while, you know what I'm saying? My melting, the logic is not getting up. Okay, that's not a thing, Donald. Like, that's not a thing. That you can't, like, in one breath to talk about how that's why I'm so great. I'm against the Iraq War. I've been against the Iraq War. That's why I'm so great. People who are for it are fucking wrong, and they're terrible for doing that. Well, your VP was for it. I don't care. That's not a thing. Like, you can't... That makes less than no sense. I don't know how anybody could have not caught themselves in that thing. But, like, okay, I actually know the answer to that. He could just override it because he's Donald Trump. So what do? On sheer force of personality and bravado and confidence and arrogance, you just throw logic out the window. You throw it out the window. In fact, we saw this with Trump on the issue of Libya. In the debates, he was like, I was against the intervention of Libya. I was against it. I was never for it. I was against it. I was against it the entire time. I was against it. I was against it. Cruz was for it. These people are for it. I was against it. I was against it. We shouldn't have done it. I was against it. He said it over and over and over and over and over. Coming to find out, boom, there's multiple recordings of him saying, we need to knock out Gaddafi. We got to go into Libya. We got to do it. We got to take him out. We gotta do it. We gotta do it. I'm for it. So he goes for it, against it. And you play the clips back to back. And you just prove it. You prove it. And his idiot followers will still be like, no. Daddy Trump said it the way that makes me feel good. It makes me comfortable when I hear him speak in his confident way. So therefore, he's right by definition, even though he said two contradictory things. He said two opposite things at the same time. But he's right because he's Daddy Trump. He's never wrong, even though he just took two different positions on the same issue. It's not possible for him to be right because of the contradiction. But I don't care. I'm going to say he's right anyway. It's how he says it. It's not what you say. It's how you say it. So when he, you know... ruthlessly and viciously and rightly rips Hillary Clinton for being for the Iraq War. And then he turns around and says, when my VP's for the Iraq War, that doesn't count. It does. He just overrides it. I don't care about your logic. I don't care about your reason. I don't care about you getting me. I'm just going to pretend like you didn't. That's it. I'll just pretend like you didn't. It's so sad. But then look at the other stuff that happened there, too. I was, you could say yes to that. You could say yes to that. Like, oh, what are you, his fucking dad and he's a toddler? Like, yeah, you say yes to that. By the way, they're talking about when he said about John McCain, yeah, he was captured. I prefer people who weren't captured. About whether or not he's a war hero. Oh, that was a gross moment. But it somehow didn't tank him, man. It didn't tank him. And now they're asking the VP, hey, did you think that was too far? Trump's like, yeah, you could say yeah. I mean, I guess you could say yeah. And when he's like, I love what he just said. Oh, it's like he's giving him a fucking report card right in front of his face and Pence is walking on eggshells. It's like his little puppet boy. And the other part that I think is really interesting and pathetically stupid is how Trump is now bragging that he picked an insider and he picked somebody who represents the establishment. Now, we all knew that that's what he did when he went with Pence. We all knew that because Pence, Koch brothers love Pence. He's taken a tremendous amount of money from special interests. He paid his fucking mortgage with political donations in his first campaign. So this guy's a deep, 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 deep insider and deeply establishment. But Trump's admitting that he's establishment and that's why he picked him. Which destroys the whole purpose of his campaign. Because he said from the beginning the whole purpose was being anti-establishment. The whole purpose was rocking the boat. The whole purpose was being an outsider. The whole purpose was to not partake in money in politics and corruption and bribery. And now he's like, yeah, I picked the guy because now we can participate in money in politics and bribery. I want to be an insider now too. So I got an insider and I'm an outsider. Huh? Huh? Yo, but that's a contradiction, you idiot. You're not supposed to admit that. You're supposed to say, like, no, he's a rebel like I am, and we're on the same page, and the core of my campaign has not changed at all. No, we're still totally anti-establishment, and fuck the money in the system, and that's terrible. Instead, he's like, no, this is good, because he's for all that stuff. He's part of the establishment, that's great. And he went on to say, establishment, that's not a bad thing. Jackass! Your whole campaign was, establishment is a bad thing! It's a bad thing, that's why you gotta go for me. Now we pick somebody who's an insider and in part of the establishment. He's like, establishment, not so bad. He's a buffoon! He's a fucking buffoon! If you can't see it based on shit like this, I have no words for you. Because you're blinded by your fandom and it's a cult of personality if you can't see the obvious logical flaws in situations like this.